An app is a program that you can use on a phone or tablet. Most computers, smartphones, and tablets come with a lot of apps already installed, but you may want to get new ones. Someone in your family may be using a social network like Instagram that you want to join, for example. Or there may be a new game that your kids want to play. A lot of things that you would do through a browser on a computer, like watching Netflix or using a social network like Facebook, you would usually do with an app on a phone or tablet. To use an app that's not already on your device, you have to download it. That means you have to add a new program to your device. You can also download other things like photos, videos, or music files. Those can come from websites, texts, emails, or other kinds of messages that people send you. Because downloading an app puts something new onto your computer or device, it comes with some risk. Sometimes you can be tricked into downloading a harmful app that puts malware on your computer. Malware are programs that make your device do things you don't want it to do. A computer virus is a type of malware. It infects your computer and makes it stop working properly. Viruses can also spread quickly to other computers. Spyware is another type of malware. It watches what you do online, like entering your bank account numbers and passwords, and sends that information to the people who made the malware. They can then use that information to get into your bank or other online accounts. To be safe, never download anything from an email, text, or other message that you are not expecting. When you're using a browser, only download from websites that you know you can trust. You should also make sure the web address starts with HTTPS rather than HTTP. Watch for the S at the end, which stands for secure, and a padlock symbol in the address bar. That means that nobody else can see the data you send to the site or that the site sends to you. When you're using a phone or tablet, make sure to only download apps from the official store. For Apple devices like iPhones, that means the App Store. Apps for Android devices should be downloaded from the Play Store. Your device should come with either the App Store or Play Store already loaded, but you will need to enter your credit card information when you open an account. Don't worry though, you shouldn't be charged for anything unless you download an app that isn't free or buy something while using an app called an in-app purchase. Remember that a lot of apps don't cost anything to download, but you may have to pay to use the full version. Others make you watch ads or try to get you to buy extra things while you're using the apps. Make sure to read what it says about the app in the App Store or Play Store before you download it, and pay attention to the information about cost. Both app stores also let users rate apps, so you can look at what other people have said about an app too before you download it. To be safe, don't download apps while using public Wi-Fi, like at a library or a coffee shop. Here's how to download an app. On an iPhone or iPad, tap the App Store icon on your screen to start. If you haven't used it before, you'll need to make an App Store account. Now you can search for the app you're interested in. You might search for the name of an app or for a particular function. For example, you might type weather to find a weather app. When you see the different choices, tap on whichever one interests you. Now you'll see information about the app. If it's free, you can download it by tapping Get. If it costs money, tap on the price. After that, you'll need to confirm that you want to buy it. Depending on your settings, you may be asked for your fingerprint or password to confirm the purchase. In the Google Play Store, you can either search for a specific app or browse by function. Now tap on any app that interests you. If you decide to download it, you can tap Install if it's free, or tap the price if it costs money. Once the app is downloaded from either the App Store or Google Play Store, an icon for it will appear on the last page on your device's home screen. While most apps are safe to use, some apps ask you to provide personal details that they don't need. Only enter information that the app requires for it to function. If an app requires you to enter unnecessary personal information before it will allow you to use it, uninstall or remove the app. If an app asks for permission to do something unusual with your phone, like make phone calls or use your camera when there's no good reason for it, say no and uninstall it. To uninstall apps from an Android device, touch the app's icon and hold until the uninstall option appears. Tap to uninstall. On the most recent iPhones, the delete app option will appear anytime you touch and hold an app's icon. Another issue to watch for with apps is how much data they use. Data is what lets you use the internet on your smartphone when you're not connected to Wi-Fi and may cost money to use depending on your rate plan. If you only use Wi-Fi, it's not as big a deal. Though things like videos can still use up your data allowance that comes with your home internet package. Downloading or updating apps when not connected to Wi-Fi will draw on your data plan. And depending on how much data you use, you may see overcharges on your phone bill if you exceed your limit. Also, many apps use data when they are open on your device by constantly refreshing and downloading information. Even a weather app will send and receive data to tell the app where you are and to send information about the weather to your device. To see how much data you're using on either an Apple or Android device, start by tapping Settings. On an iPhone or iPad, tap Cellular next. From here, you can choose which apps use data by sliding any of these switches. On an Android device, tap Data Usage next. From there, you can turn data on or off for each of your apps and set it to let you know anytime an app wants to use data. For more information on online basics, check out the other videos in this series. Visit our website at telus.com/wiseonlinebasics.